Hello everyone, welcome to Books Amaze. My name is Avni. I just finished reading this mystery thriller novel called The Curse, which is written by Mr. Debankan Das, who is from West Bengal, India. So today in this video, I'm gonna give my honest opinion about this book, what I felt about it, and should you read it or not. The story of this book is set in the year 1961, in the time of early Kolkata, which was actually Calcutta back then. And the main premise of this story is dreams and interpretation of those dreams. So I think it's a very good topic to choose, and it's very interesting because many people can easily resonate with this topic. Many times it happens that we dream some weird or supernatural things, and if we remember them, we try to decipher them. At least I did. So I was very intrigued with this plot, and I was very interested to read this story. The protagonist of our story is a 26-year-old boy named Gyanendra, who hails from a rich zamindar family. Although he is a biology student, but he is very keen in knowing and in reading about astrology from his early childhood. He likes to read books about astrology, numerics, magic, black magic, and similar topics. Now one day an incident happens where Gyanendra dreams of a weird accident, and he becomes very restless after that. And the next thing he knows is that his grandfather has died. And the way his grandfather died was somewhere very closely related to what Gyanendra dreamt of. And this incident marks the beginning of a series of some abstract dreams which Gyanendra dreams, which leads to unnatural deaths of people close to him. And later on in this story, Gyanendra actually uses his dreams to uncover a mystery to catch a criminal who has kidnapped some teenagers and is planning on murdering them. And we also discover later in the story that somehow all of these events are personally related to Gyanendra. So will he be able to solve this crime? Will he be able to find all those missing children? What challenges lies ahead? To uncover all of these mysteries, you'll have to read this novel. I really like the writing style of this book because first of all, the character of Gyanendra was introduced very well. And secondly, from the very third page of the book itself, all those dreams and the interpretation of those dreams and the actual story comes into picture. So there was no beating around the bush, no unnecessary details. The author came straight to the point, and he made sure that his readers are involved in this story right away. The story starts as a mystery thriller kind of a story, but as you progress, there are also some supernatural events that are happening. But still, I can't say that it is an out and out horror kind of a story. So the writing style creates a fine balance between a thriller and a supernatural genre. One more thing which makes the book interesting to read are the illustrations. The author has included some sketches made by himself, which are in line to the incident he is talking about. And I think these illustrations really added to the storytelling aspect. And also, all the conversations were written in italics font, which made it easier to understand. But in spite of all of these good aspects of storytelling, I felt that the characters lacks depth. The focus was given more to the plot itself than to the characters. And there were also some action sequence explained in the climax of the book, which sort of felt cliched and Bollywood-like to me. The language of this book is very simple. There were hardly any lines which were literature-wise very beautiful in this 112 long page book. So on one hand, maybe this easy language could help the beginner readers to immerse themselves easily in the plot. But on the other hand, an avid reader like me wanted more polished language, wanted more depth in characters, and wanted more description of those characters, or maybe even a simple description of Kolkata. Because there were many places in this book where an elaboration or a mere play with words was definitely possible. There were some printing mistakes in the book which can be taken care of, but there were no grammatical mistakes. Although I feel so silly talking about grammatical and printing mistakes, because this is not an ARC, it's a proper published book, so there shouldn't be any mistakes. But I really feel that the author has a lot of potential because the way he has described this story and at a very high pace is really, really commendable. You should read this book if A. you like to read books with supernatural plots in it, and B. for the simple joy of storytelling, like you used to feel when you read those Panchatantra stories. This book is not for you if A. you don't like to read books with thriller, mystery, supernatural genre, and B. if you want to read some beautiful lines or beautiful descriptions. So overall, this is a very brave attempt which could have been better with proofreading and story polishing. I really enjoyed reading about all those dreams, the not so predictable mystery, those lovely illustrations, and the creativity with which this book has been written. This is not a very big book, in fact it is quite thin, but it is very fast paced read, and I finished reading this book in just 2 hours. Because once you will start reading this, you will not be able to put it down. The pages of this book aren't glistening white. In fact, they have this sort of a yellowish tint to them. But I don't know, somehow this yellowish tint matches perfectly with this eerie theme of the book. And the cover of this book is also pretty amazing. It looks very attractive and very appealing. This book is definitely an above average for me, and I really want to give it 4 stars, but I can't because of the printing mistakes which bothered me. So I'll settle for 3.75 stars out of 5, and I'm mentioning the Amazon link of this book in the description box below. If you want to purchase this book, please go ahead and buy this book with that Amazon link. So this was my review for the book The Curse, written by Debangan Das. If you have liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it already. If you have subscribed to my channel, don't subscribe again because you will lose that subscription. I'll see you soon with another video and another story. Till then, you guys keep reading and keep smiling.